It would be very churlish of me not to recognise some of the contributions from the benches that were in front of me today. I would particularly like to mention the speeches of the Honourable Member for North East Somerset, and also the many contributions and interventions from the Honourable Member for Surrey Heath. I think these two individuals have probably done more to progress the cause of Scottish independence. I voted, of course, with my colleagues against this ill-thought-out and vastly underprepared referendum. Not only that, but at the time, myself and my colleagues, we called for, if there was to be a referendum, have the maximum franchise possible. And this government did the reverse. They denied the vote to the people whose future is most at stake, the young, the 16 to 18-year-olds. Yeah. Yeah. And of particular concern to us at the time, they refused to allow EU nationals to vote in the referendum, although we had allowed them to vote in the Scottish referendum. And I think I was the first member of this House to raise the issue of EU nationals before the vote. It was before the vote happened that what was unleashed was a horrific immigration debate bordering at times on xenophobia. Yeah. Yeah. And I talked to two of my constituents who said they felt so upset at the whole process. They were leaving the country the week before the vote and would decide their future. They did so, and sad for me, they have decided they are currently selling their house and leaving Scotland for good. They should have been welcomed here. And of course, the people who fought this immigration debate, what happened after they won? The leader of it horsed off to help a president get elected in the United States, fighting the same kind of vicious immigration xenophobic debate that got that man Trump elected. Well, I think on this day of all days we should remember a different Republican president. On this day in 1865, the House of Representatives of the United States passed the 13th Amendment to the Constitution, abolishing slavery in America. The amendment read, "Neither slavery nor involuntary servitude shall exist within the United States or any place subject to their jurisdiction." There was a statesman, Abraham Lincoln. And Abraham Lincoln, in some of his favourite lines that he carried with him all his life, he ended. I'll end with some of Abraham Lincoln's favourite lines that will be recognised by many. "Then let us pray that come it may, as come it will for a' that, that sense and worth for a' the earth shall bear the gree and a' that. For a' that and a' that, it's coming yet for a' that. That man to man, the world hour, shall brothers be for all that."